Hello guys, in today's video I'm going to show you how to add RGB LEDs to your FPV drone. This mod not only looks amazing but also has some practical benefits. If you've ever wanted your drone to stand out in the sky, or make it easier to find after a crash, then stick around, because I'll walk you through every step. I'll be upgrading my Mark V drone with these RGB LEDs from SpeedyBee. The great thing is that these LEDs weigh only 8 grams, so they won't affect your drone's performance or flight time much at all. The Mark V uses the SpeedyBee F405 V4 flight controller, which conveniently has extra pads on the corners specifically for LEDs. These are perfect for this kind of mod. We'll be mounting the LEDs on top of the arms. Why? Well, this positioning helps protect them during rough landings, especially if you're landing on rocks or other hard surfaces. It's all about keeping your gear safe while looking cool. So, without further ado, let's get started. First things first, let's remove the propellers. It's always a good idea to take off the props whenever you're working on the electronics of your drone. Safety first. Next, we'll need to remove the top plate. This gives us better access to the solder pads on the flight controller. We want to make sure we have enough space to work comfortably. Now that everything is open, it's time to prep the LED wires. I cut the wires to the right length, making sure they're not too long or too short. Then, I add a bit of solder to the ends of the wires. This helps make the soldering process easier and ensures a good connection. I also add a little solder to the pads on the flight controller. This will help the wires stick better when we solder them in place. And there we go, the first LED is soldered. The SpeedyBee LEDs can operate in two modes, standalone and betaflight. In standalone mode, you can change the color using this button here. But if you want more control, you can switch to betaflight mode by holding the button down for a few seconds. I'll go ahead and solder the rest of the LEDs onto the flight controller. So, if you're enjoying the video so far, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Your support means a lot to me. Once all the LEDs are in place, I use the included heat shrink tubing to cover the connections. This not only secures the wires, but also gives it a cleaner look. To mount the LEDs onto the arms, I use double-sided tape. This keeps everything in place, even during intense flights. Now that the LEDs are installed, let's move on to the trickier part, configuring them in betaflight. This can be a bit confusing at first, but don't worry, I'll guide you through it. First, you need to activate the switch button for LED strips in the configuration tab. This allows Betaflight to recognize the LEDs connected to your flight controller. Once that's done, switch over to the LED strip tab. Here, you can configure the LEDs to behave exactly how you want. I've set up my LEDs so that I can turn them on and off using the aux channels on my transmitter. I can also change the colors, which is a nice touch. Unfortunately, I haven't figured out how to dim the LEDs using the aux channels. But for now, on and off will do the trick. Here's a look at the Betaflight configuration. When you wire the LEDs in parallel, they'll all react the same way. But if you want to control each LED individually, you'll need to wire them in series. I highly recommend setting up the on and off switch on your aux channel. These LEDs are incredibly bright, so it's great to have the option to turn them off when you don't need them. Changing the color is more of a fun feature, but not strictly necessary. One practical benefit of adding these LEDs is that it makes finding your drone much easier if it crashes. The lights stand out, even in tall grass or low light, making recovery quicker and less stressful. Overall, it's a fun mod that isn't essential, but definitely enhances the flying experience. Plus, It makes it much easier for spectators to keep track of your drone during a flight. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more, don't forget to subscribe. Creating these videos takes a lot of time, and your subscription is like a reward for my efforts. And by the way, if you're interested in the build of my Mark V, you can check it out right here. See you in the next video. No.